Hi guys, today we are going to discuss about types and declarations, type checking. So declaration itself means that type declaration only. So ultimately we are going to look at declarations and type checking. This is what the last topic of your unit 4 discussion. If you look at each language has its own data type. We need to understand every language, what are all the options it provides for the data types. We need to learn that first. Subsequently, why the declaration is essential, that we should understand. Normally, when you are starting a C program, after main function, you will use to use open curly brackets. Subsequently, you will be starting with local declaration. Before main function, after the preprocessor section, whatever you declare, that is treated as global declaration. Whatever may be the declaration, you are insisted to inform about the data type. If you look at Python language, there is no declaration at all. Naturally, it is taking the values which is given on the RHS, given on the LHS, it will be given on the RHS, it will be considering to the LHS. So every language, it varies. Whereas if it is considered Java language, you need to create all the data type instantiation, all the data type abstract initialization, instantiation you need to do. Only then you can proceed further for the data usage or expression evaluation. Every language has got its own terms, its own conditions. So naturally, you need to understand how these all are functioning. If you consider C language, the purpose is different. C++, anywhere you can declare. Whenever you want the data type or data need to be used, variable need to be used or constant need to be used, you are permitted to declare any part of the C++ language. When it comes Python, totally it gives you the freedom for the user. We no need to mention about, we no need to think everything and one particular structured programming language like C, you need to declare everything first before even you work. Whereas C++ gives a little amount of freedom, whenever it is required, we can declare the variable. Whereas if you come to Python, there is no need of anything to be declared at all. Depending upon the pattern, if you want to create a list, you can give it in the square bracket. If you want to create a tuple, you can give it in the parenthesis. Similarly, if you want to create a dictionary, you can use the colon. The moment you use colon and curly bracket, it will be treated as dictionary. And as the same curly bracket, if you don't use colon, it will be treated as a set. So it has a pattern. Depending upon it, what the user is mentioning on the RHS, accordingly, LHS will take the morphism. What is a morphism? It will take the change in association. So it will take its own adjustment. Morphism is the right word I can say in Python. So it will take the morphism. So we all need to think how the compiler is working like this. Unless otherwise it is dictated to the compiler what to do, how to do, how many data types, it is very impossible to recognize user written program, even to teach the programming language to the user, it will be very difficult. So it is systematic. Every language has got its own systematic approach towards the declaration. Depending upon that systematic approach only, that compiler developer writing the manual or writing the book or publications, something. Nowadays, python.org, if you see, every package, every library, there is appropriate manual has been released. It is a kind of textbook like python.org available. That is a original and flawless website. That is a contributors themselves they are doing. So everywhere, people are contributing, that is documented. That document only we are referring in terms of textbook or in terms of web material or YouTube video or material provided by the teachers. Whatever the way we learn, that all the origin has come out of the contributor, the compiler developer. So they will be mentioning the data type, nature of the declaration, how to declare, when to declare, how to go for type conversion. If we look at Python, input is the only function available to get input from the user. Any input you tend to give, it will be treated as a string. Then if you want to convert into integer or float, what type of data you want, you need to go for explicit type conversion. So that is a trick they have kept there. We need to convert it into integer or float or whatever the value we wanted to take it forward. When you consider Python language, no range specification. C is highly bounded to range. Based on the range, C language gives like this. You have int A, int is one data type. This is depending upon that range of the data type. We have range. Whereas in Python, there is no range. Range means it will tell that 2 bytes. It tell that 4 bytes. So it has, rather than the bytes also, it has a range. Negative value association to the positive value. What is the size? Exactly what is the value, the range of values you can assign for it. When I say 2 bytes, it is related to memory allocation. When I say negative range of values, positive range of values, that is the exact value you can store with respect to the variable A. Beyond that, you cannot think of what to do. Then, when it comes, the range is exceeded in C language, you have short. If it is shorter, you need to go for short int. If it is longer, you need to go for long int. If it is long int, long int you can go for. Long int is permitted. So based on this all though specification, these all mentioned in the type declaration. Now you can ask question, where these manuals are available? How these manuals are available? We all know that we started with lexical analysis phase. I'll come back to the discussion again. Lexical analysis phase we discuss. Subsequently, we moved on to the syntactic analyzer. Then semantic analyzer. We moved on to the semantic analyzer. This is part of semantic analyzer. That is the reason we are discussing now. This type checking is part of declaration, or these all verification are part of this. This much we should know. So it is part of semantic analyzer. Soon after the syntactic analyzer, it does. When it comes C language, these are all the way or the rules or the boundaries we need to understand. When it comes Python, we no need to maintain these many 4 versions. Just you can create a variable, you can assign 10000. I can assign. Accordingly, it will take the morphism. The memory morphism is happening when it comes to Python. When it is C language, you are bound to use, bound to represent what is the range of values or the memory allocation you are expecting. These all are written into the manual. Depending upon the way you are mentioning, it will allocate a memory. It will mention the range of values to be given. If any one of you try to violate this, you will be facing fatal error. It will either generate fatal error, or it will ignore, it will truncate automatically some amount of information. You will be giving one type of information, but the value which is available in the variable would become different. When you try to print and display it, it will come in different way. So that automatically something collapse will happen, or either error will happen. Whenever you are declaring something, you would have noticed a fatal error. Whenever you create a linked list, stack and graph, and whenever you work with the trees, whenever you are going for complex data structures, circularly linked list, doubly circularly linked list, then immediately the requested memory is not available in that memory declaration portion. You will be notified with a fatal error. I used to face, maybe I can say 15 years ago, I used to teach continuously every semester VC++. Whenever VC++ we are touching upon most of the initialization, instantiation will happen. So due to that, if you are trying for more number of allocation without the subject knowledge, just like that, nowadays, if you are permitted to declare array now, you will be declaring A of 200, A of 500. You may use only two elements, sum of two number, but you tend to declare like that unknowingly. So when it becomes VC++, those days, the processor are not even Intel 5, Intel 7. It is lesser those kind of processor version. Recent days only you are enjoying this all. So quite often those guys used to get a fatal error. Most of the time my duty would be fixing the fatal error when I was teaching the VC++ during the lab sessions. That a fatal error is indication of memory inadequate circumstances. So whenever fatal error you are getting, you need to revisit the pointer references, how you are using. Especially this is highly associated with the pointer association. Why pointer association? So whenever the memory is contiguously, with the moment you create a program or execute a program, you may declare 5 variable, you may declare 50 variable. So relevant to your program, it will be allocated contiguously. That continuous memory location, I mean to say. Then whenever the references are created for the next, internally it uses lot of pointers than even explicit pointers. So by the time the referencing issues may arise, that insufficient memory location may be the problem when it starts addressing. Slowly in the latest processor, these are all those things resolved. Advanced processor becoming smart. Recent days, AI enabled processors also becoming up. AI enabled CPU, depending upon the scheduling and idle situation, when to go for idle situation, when to go for resume, how to clean the memory. Whenever the programs are idle for certain duration, but again the user tries to come back. Say I used to open 5 to 20 tabs every day, then I don't know when I will revisit, but it will be there. So when the person is trying to revisit, it will be loaded back. So lot of dynamic way of cleaning, scheduling, resource allocation, these are all happening recent days. These attempts are going on and maybe successful also. That much I am not sure. So, but if we start looking at research literature, it says that lot of AI enabled processes are going. So deadlock avoidance, semaphores. So you would have studied in operating system. So entirely it is taking care of much more intelligent way than the static algorithm. Those days we used to write a static algorithm that based on that algorithm only the computer performance or operations will be carried out. But whenever we look at the recent day processor, it is trying to become AI enabled. So these all will take care of all the dynamic situations. Because of the dynamic situations only, they are going for AI enabled. So these are all the reasons. So try to understand every language, the way to convert it will become different. It is a kind of shuttle topic, not concretely we will be discussing SDT, something like that. Because for this case, SDT would become different for each and every language. But we are going to look at what are all the activities carried out. Let us move. Language has its own data type. This is what I said. We cannot compare one language to another language. When we look at C language, we have structured data type, heterogeneous data collection. When you come to C++, you have templates, you have classes and objects. So for the heterogeneous attributes or aggregation. So every language has its own way of data type profiles. So next, every data type, based on the data type rules, the type rules, each compiler need to check the type of the data. Very first step is it will start checking the type of the data provided by the user. Next, accordingly, it will go for memory allocation, range check, evaluation assignment. These are all the three major steps. There are many more also. Let us start with these three. What is memory allocation? The moment the user tend to give, even in Python, memory need to be allocated. Even in C, memory need to be allocated. Even if it is Java, C++, the moment you create object, the moment you initialize object, immediately the memory allocation happening. Next, range check. Every data type tend to have the range of values. Beyond that, it's not possible. Even I'm not concrete about Python. How long we can keep on increasing the values, I don't know. I need to verify or I need to study on it. So when it comes C language, it is clearly specified. Even C++ clearly specified. What is the range of each and every data type? That range check. Even for Python, it would be there. We cannot use sarcastically whatever the number we are expecting. It is not possible, I guess. Next, evaluation assignment. Whenever expressions are evaluated, see, you may declare int A, then you may declare float B, C, then you will tend to evaluate in any combination. See, what are all the possibilities are available for the evaluation? You may try to do A is equal to B into C or division. Then you may try to do B is equal to A into C. Then you may try to do C is equal to A into C. Seems to be simple, but it has a lot of intricacies or type check internally. Look at here, you are using integer variable on the LHS. Here you are involving both type as a float data type. Either you need to promote the value before assign this value. Variable you need to promote, or you need to truncate the values and before assigning. Whenever the expression evaluation is happening, again the explicit type conversion is one method, or implicit type conversion or coercion is another method. If user tend to give explicitly, this is depending upon the user. User need to define it. Explicit, it will happen automatic by the compiler. So whatever may be these type conversions, type compatibility. The next one is type compatibility. Beyond these all, you may not able to do for certain cases. You need to work based on compatibility. These are all the three steps carried out by the compiler during the execution or evaluation. So these are all the three possible scenarios. With that one example itself, we can demonstrate RHS both are involved with a float, LHS becoming the integer, and whenever you look at here, you are mixing the data type A and C on the RHS, then you are assigning to the float. Then when it comes here, yeah, it can be B or anything. B, A, C. What is other combination? B here, A, C here, B, A, C. There is no more combination. Only these are all the two possibilities available. So whenever this, there is no more combination. So whenever these types are differing from each other, LHS and RHS, type conversion or type compatibility verification, or if it will verify for user mentioned or not. If it is not mentioned for the suitable context, it will pop up with the error. If it is permitted, if it is written in the manual or compiler, automatically it will go for explicit conversion. Sorry, implicit conversion. However, implicit conversion, what is expected value may get, may not get. Expected values by the user may or may not be possible. Whatever you are expecting, that is not for sure. So you need to be thorough on how it is evaluating. These are all the three steps considered during the evaluation. Evaluation time, either it will do explicit type conversion verification or implicit type conversion or type compatibility. Next, range check, that value, assigned value, then number allocation. So this is what evaluation assignment only. I have mentioned LHS equal to RHS. And the symbol table entries. Symbol table entry right now just hold for some time. However, you feel difficulty or understanding also. Subsequently, unit number 5 is dealt with half of the unit symbol table alone. How to create symbol table? What are all the entries will go into the symbol table? What is the purpose of symbol table? How symbol table is associated, attached with all the phases of the compiler, right from the lexical analyzer to the code generator or code evaluator, whatever. So all those stuff we will be slightly postponing, but however you try to understand, now this type checking is highly associated with symbol table. So next, type checker is a module of the compiler. This is one module, not the phase. Understand? That is the reason we are discussing slightly, not like a phase. The primary use of this type checking is during the declaration as well as during the evaluation or runtime as well as, ultimately I mean to say, declaration as well as during the evaluation means two steps, static and dynamic check. During the execution, if the type checking is carried out, that is called dynamic check. During the compilation, if the type checking is carried out, that is static. That's it. The design of the checker depends on the syntax structure of the language which you want to do. We cannot assure this. Language to language, it differs depending upon the syntactic structure and language construct. That means compiler, developer, how they designed and how they thought of. That is what language construct. Guys, I think I shared the video, the recent video I have come across across the YouTube. 2000 lines, 200 lines, if sufficient for Python, with Python writing a compiler. Those kind of thing you can start exploring. Only then you can think of contributing to the Julia open language community or Python open language community. So that is how you need to grow. Or else you can go to GitHub and you can, how to design a compiler, you can explore whenever you are feeling quite comfortable. Once the laboratory session is started, then I would be addressing those all. By the time this semester, if at all, I would be continuing for the lab handling. I expect whomever possible to do, you can do. I will be considering as a bonus mark for you all guys, those who are involving in the compiler, mini compiler development. Or you can develop a compiler for the native language also. You can just attempt. You can try how you can parse the string of Telugu or Hindi, any language you can choose, vernacular language other than English. So you can choose and you can try attempting that way. Or you can explore the GitHub content and execute. Or you can couple several tools together. OpenText has a lot of tools. And Lex is one tool, Yaki is one tool. You can couple several tools together and you can work for or develop a mini incomplete compiler is also fine. So if you are taking it up as a mini project, that would be better to showcase in your resume as well as a part of academic entertainment or academic progress. I'll be considering those kind of projects. By that time, let us look into other aspects of compiler development. Okay, type checker is involved between syntactic analyzer and semantic analyzer. That is what I mentioned here. See, look at here. I'm just reading, that's all. Already everything has been articulated. So it is available in between these two or works cohesively all along with, semantic analyzer. Now, next point. Where we stopped, compiler statistic and variable or procedure has to be declared before it can be used. Declaration involves allocation of memory space, entry of type and name in the symbol table. So both of the work carried out during the type checking. So it will first go for memory reservation, then it will go for symbol table entries. Those are all the two responsibilities. Look at here. Memory allocation is done in the consecutive manner. This is what I said, continuous memory allocation. Names are allocated to the memory in the sequence order. Offset variable is set to zero for the first variable, offset. This offset only guides for the memory allocation. I just give you a small demonstration. Int A, float B, character C. Let us imagine. These are all the three variable we are trying to convert it into C language. We are declaring it into C language. What it will do is offset value will be set as zero initially. Then for A, what is the before this declaration, how internally will happen, I'll show. So offset value is initialized with 0. Now here offset is calculated for A. 0 offset for A is equal to 0. Because this is the first variable, then offset would become 0 naturally. The syntactic director translation, what further it will do is type of A or size of A. It will start calculating size of A. What is the number of bytes? Now these two steps will be carried out in this line, this particular declaration association. Subsequently, what will happen is this offset is updated as for A, size of A, this is what your offset. What is the size of A? 2 byte. So this offset may be 0, or you can imagine this address may be 2000 A also. Just for demonstration purpose, I am telling. Internally, you don't assume all the time it is 0. Some initial value would be there. So just for convenience type, I am taking offset equal to 0 for the first variable. There would be some other offset also. This offset would become initial address pointer for integer A internally. It will create a pointer references. When it becomes float B, size of A would be the offset for B. This is the starting address for the B. Size of A. Now it will try to calculate size of B. Now how the offset is calculated? It will go with, now the addition process will happen. Offset, original offset plus size of A plus, that is plus size of A. This is what will happen now. Or address of B. Here you can say address of plus size of B, because varying nature. Here what will happen again if you want to rewrite address of A plus size of A. These are all the syntactic director translation or abstract translations will happen during the declaration itself by the compiler. Internally, this will happen. This a part is executed or considered during the declaration. Every time address need to be fixed for every variable. These all varying in nature. You may declare multiple variable also. So then accordingly it needs to adjust and it needs to set the memory location. This is the primary role of type checking and the declaration. Two different part we are discussing. Declaration part and type checking part. Now let us walk through with one example, program example. Consider int A, float B. The same only I was trying to tell. But this piece of information I have taken from the internet. Allocation process starts, offset equal to 0, int A, id.type also it will calculate. This is the role of type checker. id.width also calculated. Offset is calculated, offset plus id.width. What is the width? It is given here, 2. So the offset will become 2. Then float B. id.type float, id.width 4. What is the earlier offset value? 2. What is the new id width? 4. Offset equal to 6. This is systematically written. This I am giving a rough way of explanation. So that whichever the way you want, you can adapt for your examination point of view. But both of the way I am illustrating. So next, in addition to this memory allocation, what is the other aspect carried out by this type checker is it will enter the details into the symbol table. Name of the variable, type of the variable, what is the offset value? These are all the three, even width or size also, it will give size of the variable as well. If it is possible, it will give even range. So these are all the information. Then the scope, we will be discussing shortly in the next unit. Scope means global or local. Scope means how much the visibility of the variable is accepted across the program. That is the meaning. So this is the subsequent role carried out during the type checking process. Now let us see one by one. Look at here. Type checking. basic or derived data type. Static nature of type checking is happening with C language and Java language. Dynamic nature of type checking happening with Lisp as well as Python. Two different types of type checking. In general, types of data types would be considered into basic and derived data type. Int is example, the way you declare int is basic data type. Derived data type, structure is derived data type, array is derived data type, or if you say simply long int, it is also derived data type. So there are two different data types available almost in all the modern languages. One is basic data type, another one is derived data type. Again, further type checking happens both static in nature during the compilation time. This, the moment you say static nature, it means that compilation time it is happening. The moment you say dynamic in nature, it means that during execution time it is happening. This much understanding is sufficient. What is type checking? Collection of computational entities and that shares this common properties. What is common property? Look at here. So ID type, ID width, offset. So these are all the common properties. It will be executed and considered throughout the execution. Check for the operands of expected types and expressions are well typed. Check for the operand and expressions type. This is what I mentioned here. Look at here. This is what operand. A, B and C, these are all operand. So this compatibility check. So type checking role is this also. Next, determines the range of values and set the operations that are defined for values. Whatever I said, just I'm reading now. Rules for assigning types to programming language construct. All the type assignment, whether int to float assignment is accepted or float to int assignment is accepted or any combination of assignment is accepted. These are all the type verification. Why types are required? Program organization and documentation. Consistent interpretation of bits in memory. So always we need to understand how it behaves and how that the compiler works. So there is no inconsistency. Always it is transparent, it should become and consistent. Compiler can take advantage of type information for the better performance. So type information will be helpful for the performance, deciding the algorithm, things like that. Now this is another example for record data type. This is Pascal construct, Pascal language. If you wish, you can refer, otherwise not required. Whatever it is mentioned there, that is sufficient. That's all. So above, all roles are carried out by the type checker, verifies the size, range of the data type. Indexing for arrays. Memory pointer, references for pointers. I just introduced very simple level of this type checker. When it becomes further indexing, then offset calculation, it will be little bit tricky. Two dimensional array, it will be little more tricky. Memory pointer, these all you would have studied in your data structure. Hope that you are all expertise in data science. The design of type checking depends on syntax and nature of the compiler constructor. Type checking is carried out before the intermediate code generation. That is what I said. This is associated with semantic analyzer. Either way you can write, that is one way of writing is sufficient. Either you can write type checking is carried out before or after the syntactic analyzer or along with the semantic analyzer. Any three way of representation or writing, you can go ahead or you can proceed with. With that note, I'm concluding today's session.